Alright, let's go see what's happening over here. Map.
The Lyrians entered the graveyard. Crickets chirped in its tall, windswept grass, and lush green moss covered its crumbling gravestones. Only a fresh bloodstain upon a mausoleum wall suggested that something disturbed the dead in their rest and hunted the living.
Save your tears! Throw off your grief!
An eerie voice sang, its ghastly lament standing Meave's hair on end.
Soon your life too shall cease. As you pass into the eternal gloom.
A pockmarked, pustule-ridden creature crawled out from behind some gravestones. It vaguely resembled a shriveled, hunchbacked hag, until its head split into two halves, forming a tooth-spiked maw.
Attack! Everyone!
There's a time to reap, a time to sow, and a time to die. Lyria!
What? Who dares?
One bullet's all I need. There's a time to reap, a time to sow. I'm a monster. Aye.
What? Who dares?
Lyria! One bolt.
What was that filth?
The queen croaked hoarsely as the dying monster writhed in agony at her feet.
I know not, Your Grace,
replied Reynard.
But to be safe, I would have the corpse chopped up and burnt.
urge upon the air? Or was it just the wind whistling past mossy tombstones?
I like that one. That one's better. Alright, let's pick up all this stuff. Queen, one of the destroyed graves belonged to an elven mage. We might find something of worth, but we would like first need to dedicate sufficient resources to have the resource. Oh, it's just 100 gold, that's easy. Yeah, another part of the card. Perfect. Nothing over there? Okay. Anything here? No. What about here? Is there anything to loot over here? No loot? Okay. No loot over there. Let's look over here. Nothing there. How do you get down there? That area over here, maybe you have to wait. How'd you get here? Okay, There has to be a way to get over there. There has to be a way to get along there. Fast travel. How do you use fast travel? Okay, that's cool.
Kneel and pay homage to the god.
Traveling the high road, they heard the bells of a temple to Mother Melitele, situated at some distance. Meave turned towards Reynard.
What have we today? A sacred feast?
Not that I recall, Your Grace.
The Queen's brow darkened, her hands clenched into fists on her reins.
Then they sound the alarm. Umi!
Follow me, okay.
Stained glass shards glinted in the grass. Bits of down, ripped from quilts, wafted through the air. The priestesses, gathered in the yard, were seeing to wounded pilgrims, setting toppled, oft beheaded or armless statues back on their feet.
What happened here?
The Strait of Spala fell upon us,
sighed the prioress.
Stole the offerings, the monstrances, holy books. My lady, I implore you, come to our aid. Recover what's rightly ours.
Ever clever, Meave's scouts soon discovered the bandits' tracks. They led to some thick hazel groves east of the temple. The perfect place to hide, or to lie in ambush. The Queen was downcast as she left the abbey. Though most of the strays had likely ridden towards Lord Claydon's estate, some were clearly still foraging nearby.
This must end.
The Queen tightened her grip on her reins.
At once. It's all come clear now. Sabotage. 'Twas the bandits who weakened the walls.
The good mother warned us. Hard t- The good mother wa- The good mo-
Your Majesty, turn back! There's something...
Tiny vettles, hungry like a wolf I am.
Lyria!
One bolt.
Give me a target.
Ballista, your command.
What? Who dares?
I'm a lord, sir.
Lyria!
I need to think about the order of my cards.
Tiny vettles, hungry like a wolf I am.
Abelista, your command. Armor wants it.
Wait, I could get that one up to number to one on the first try.
Gloria!
One bolt.
What? Who dares?
Give me a time. Abelista, your command.
Perfect. Something there? No further. Okay. Monster has defiled one of the cocoons, lay waste to a sacred grave, bones like a crown. Your treasure is enough to fill your coffins of wars. It's surely the dead need one, right? Shall we follow this place? Leave the treasures, seal the tomb.
Your Majesty, you return. Our prayers have been answered.
May the
Your Majesty, you return.
May the Mother Goddess watch.
Your Majesty.
Ah, there it is. I wonder if that opens that lock. Oh! Secret loot!
The bandits had pitched camp in a nearby wood. Spirits buoyed by the wine they'd stolen from the cloister cellar, the brigands had not posted sentries.
Up, down, to the sisters!
Neve's soldiers were eager, insistent. The desecrators would be punished. Yet only the queen could...
High time we put these strays on a leash,
spat the queen, spurring her horse.
To arms! Follow me!
Tankards clattered to the ground as the strays reached for their weapons. The brigands would not even fathom giving.
Thank you.
them!
For Rivia! Got a death wish?
Left, right, left, right.
A lamb, the shank.
See if he's had any coin in his pockets or his own.
Regroup.
Again and again and again.
You might have got away had you not been hauling so damn much.
There's not a reason why.
Miss gonna pass me those lovely earrings, or do I tear them off myself?
One gold.
No time for that.
Her Majesty knows what she's doing.
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
If you insist.
Give me a time.
That bit the white of an eye from half a league away.
Tell me you jest.
I'm coming.
The Queen's company defeated the bandits and recovered the loot. Silver chalices, reliquaries lined with mother of pearl, gold embroidered robes.
The priestesses would be grateful to have their treasures returned, Your Grace. They would pray ardently for your victory.
Reynard opined.
Yet, you could also keep the silver, expend it on the war effort. And who's to say which, prayer or coin, would be more useful?
The Queen said, after a pause.
Yet this can't justify a lapse in principles. No. We must defend them all the more.
Meave ordered everything returned to the priestesses. All of it, down to the last gulden. Moved by the Queen's gesture, some of the novitiates joined Meave's ranks, aiming to bring succor to any Lyrian wounded in battle. Queen and company rode off, with no gold to show for their toil. Only richer in spirit.
Sure, you can bind a rabbit.
Arrow!
Take any more.
One bullet's all I need.
Give me a time.
There's a time to reap, a time to sow, and a time to die.
A lesson in humility coming now.
Tiny vettles. Hungry like a wolf I am.
Arbalista, your command.
Ours is not to reason why.
What do you want of me?
Tiny vettles. Hungry like a wolf, I am.
Left, right, left, right.
Sweat like a swine in that jacket.
Lyria!
Aye.
I shouldn't waste all my cards at the same time. That's what I did, because I wasted all my cards right at the beginning of the match. Yeah. I guess that was just a side quest and not a main story quest.
Thank you, Your Majesty, on our own behalf, and on that of our pilgrims.
Thank you. ahead and continue.
Thank you, Your Majesty, on our own behalf and on that of our pilgrims. Thank you, Your Majesty, on our own behalf.
Suddenly, Meave's force found itself marching straight towards a Nilfgaardian company. To the Queen's surprise, the invaders did not immediately assume battle formation. They proceeded instead in her very direction without a sign of panic. The man leading the Nilfgaardians was clad in rich robes. He exuded pride and the scent of musk.
I am Traherne Vardifir, Your Majesty. I was asked to present your esteemed grace the ultimatum of the forces of the Empire of Nilfgaard.
The envoy cracked the seal on a scroll, unfurled it, took a deep breath, and began to read.
I, General Ardal Ebdahi, demand immediate and unconditional surrender of Lyria and Rivia. Elsewise, I will burn down every city, town, village and temple, place all your subjects in chains, and your armed men, defeated and captured, I will hang along the roadsides as a warning to all others in the barbarous north.
As the final threat echoed in Meave's ears, the envoy put away the scroll and stood waiting for her answer, a mocking smile on his face. He allowed himself this insolence, believing the immunity accorded diplomats would shield him from any form of royal ire.
I thank you, sir. A sophisticated missive that proves beyond a doubt Nilfgaard's superiority over the culturally backward north.
Answered the Queen in a voice frostier than Mahakam's snow-capped peaks.
To delay this matter, I see no reason. So I give you my response to His Excellency. Go ahead and try, Horson.
That said, Meave slapped her mount with her reins and galloped away, leaving the Nilfgaardians in dust. Envoy and escort turned to go whence they came, the Lyrians sending them off with a din of whistles and curses.
Chest. damage and anticipate to point the elites. Sure, join us. Attack their base.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Hundred and one, 102, 103.
Left, right, left, right.
Thank you.
What do you want of me?
One bullet's all I need.
Give me a target. Arbalista, your command.
Lyria!
Scrubbing duty again? Oh, gorge. Plenty in them.
Oh, Lyrian lummoxes.
One bolt I need.
Listen to me, old lady.
Hey, Hector.
Off to the front yet again.
Give me a target.
Quiet! The Commissar will hear.
What? Who dares?
Hey, Hunter.
Yes? Enarfian!
You must sweat like a swine in that jacket.
This artist will be reaping black clad heads.
Ugh! Scheiß! In train!
Hope you have the same amount of cards. Why does he stay there? Oh, resilience.
Thank you.
New orders? No?
Again and again and again.
Help, God!
Tell me you jest.
There's not to reason why.
Off to the front yet again.
Arbalist at your command.
Tiny vettles. Hungry like a wolf I am.
New orders? No?
I'm a wolf, sir.
Must be an important lesson in this. But what?
Hundred and one, 102, 103.
I'm coming.
Off to the front yet again.
Was a waste of time for one like me.
Give me a time.
Ha!
sound aplenty.
There's a time to reap, a time to sow, and a time to die. Arbalista, your command.
If you insist.
I'm a warrior.
Left, right, left, right.
Help, God!
Tell me you jest.
Lyria!
It hurts her.
We must trust each other.
Aye. Ah, should have listened to me old lady.
Right.
One bolt I need. Give me a target. Ballista, your command. Armor wants it. One bolt's all I need. Give me a target. I'm a monster. Lariat!
one bolt I need. Give me a time.
Ballista, your command.
Then one day, gazing towards the horizon, the Queen spotted Lyrian banners whipping about in the wind.
At long last,
she said with a smile. Meave resolved to speak with the commander, one Baronet Eldar. It was the first time they met, and the youth very much impressed her. Yet instead of questioning Eldar about the foe's troop movements, Reynard took the conversation down a seemingly irrelevant path.
And how's your father, if I may ask? In good health, I hope?
Yes, though he still nurses that bump he suffered while hunting last winter. Yet he's not one to complain. I'll tell him you asked.
Irritated at the trivial nature of the conversation, Meave gave her horse a dose of her reins and cantered off. Once Eldar and his men were safely behind them, she took Reynard aside.
Reynard, this is no time for gossip and pleasantries. We are at war.
Yes, Your Majesty. And in such times, little should be taken at face value. Even a man's name.
Get to the point, Reynard.
Eldar's father died a month past. His son, I venture, should have known as much.
But that means... Oh, the bastard. Impeccable accent, though.
I fear he's rather representative of what we face. Nilfgaardian spies are ever well prepared.
Tell me, how did you know?
He wears no mourning on his armor. Were it not for that, I dare say I might never have guessed. What are your orders, Your Grace? To observe these Nilfgaardian mummers?
Assemble a force. Tell them to follow our new allies. Observe them closely.
As you wish, Your Grace.
Reynard's scouts did as ordered, watching the Falklands while themselves remaining unseen. Soon after, a scout returned with news that the False Lyrians seemed headed for Rastburg, a castle several leagues to the north.
barn, granary. Begged of me, lady. We offend their emperor some ways, your majesty. We offend their emperor some...
The false Lyrians approached Rasburg Castle. They sought to convince the defenders to open the gate. As their commanders negotiated with the commander on the ramparts, the remaining infiltrators crouched hidden behind a wall, awaiting the signal to rush forth.
Time for Baronet Elder to join his falsely claimed father,
muttered the Queen.
Follow me!
They found us! Sega not to mean!
Alba!
Left, right, left, right.
Then retreat!
Keep calm, Tiberius.
Give me a time.
Ballista, your command.
Off to the front yet again.
this I will hear.
I'm a warrior.
Rach! Scheiß! In tight!
Discipline, that is what you folk lack.
Listen to me, old lady.
There you go. We must trust each other. Castle is secure, Your Grace.
The Nilfgaardians found themselves in a clinch. As boiling oil and tar rained down on them from the walls, they attempted to retreat. Yet Meave's halberdiers cut off their path, and at the fight's end, Meave was victorious. The garrison commander now knelt by the body of the purported Baronet Eldar, in truth, a Nilfgaardian spy. He shook his head in disbelief.
He addressed me by name. Knew our watchwords. Why, if you hadn't come along, Your Grace, I fear even to think on it.
Let this be a lesson, then. Trust no one, not a living soul.
Though victory was theirs, the Lyrians left Rathg in mightily low spirits. They now knew well that Nilfgaard's spies were no less a threat than its heavy cavalry. Than its war machines that spit fire.
And we defended the castle. One of the castles.
Milady, if I may, the enemy yet lurks. You must bolster your force. You must incorporate a detachment from my... Oh, times, the world, the day. Can't even tell friend from foe. Treachery round every corner.
Don't worry. We're leery.
What the devil is going on? Where are our reinforcements? Why does Willem not ride out to face the foe, relieve besieged towns?
I can't say, Your Grace. We haven't had a single scroll from the Prince.
Gods be damned! I've the impression I'm alone in fighting the Black Cluds.
Beware, my lady. Keep a keen watch. Heard the thunder of hooves from the high road. Cries ferocious in a foreign tongue.
Your Majesty, what of Prince Willem? Where is he? Why has he not come to relieve us?
We died of omens.
oddities that foretold this war. Blood in the milk, stillborn foes, treat we died home.
Meave's retinue was riding through a narrow gully when a shrill cry cut the air.
Anvan in order!
The gully came alive, and soldiers in black armor rushed forth. A cry in turn went up and down Meave's ranks. Ambush!
Hundred and one, 102, 103.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Uh-huh. 152, 154.
Left, right, left, right.
Alba!
Can't take it anymore.
I'm a monster.
Keep calm, Tiberius.
Lyria!
My prescription, a bit of bloodletting.
I'm coming.
Quiet! Oh, the Commissar will hear.
This artist will be reaping black clad heavens.
Tell me you jest.
Got any victuals? Hungry like a wolf I am.
Off to the front yet again.
A highly curious case.
Give me a time.
After the skirmish, the Queen's troops brought several Nilfgaardian prisoners before her. Reynard, who had the best command of their mongrel tongue, interrogated. His first question? How many battalions were marching on Dravograd?
Kes, Zagdran, Ep, Dravograd, Ven.
The prisoners whispered feverishly, then one spoke on their behalf. They would answer no questions until the Queen pledged to free them in return. The Lyrian soldiers saw this as arrogance and said as much.
Conditions they're giving us now? Sons of whores! I say, we find a tree with a strong bough, several.
I know not the custom in Nilfgaard, but here in the north, the vanquished do not make demands.
Meave gazed at the prisoners.
Since you do not wish to speak, you shall remain forever silent. Ready a rope!
That day, Meave demonstrated she would show the invaders no mercy. The Lyrians marched off, strengthened in their resolve, prepared to fight to the death.